Welcome to WatchGuard's Daily Security Byte. I'm your host, Corey Nachreiner. There's a lot of news today, but the big story is Ghost, a major Linux vulnerability. This is a flaw in the GNUC library. If you're not an engineer or Linux expert, you may not know what this library is, but it's a very popular component that ships with many Linux servers, and many other software programs rely on functions in this library to do things, such as resolve DNS or domain names. And that particular function in glibc is vulnerable to a new buffer overflow vulnerability, which Qualys researchers have talked about today. This is a pretty serious vulnerability since many Linux packages use that particular function to resolve DNS. So an attacker might do something like send a simple email, and that email may cause remote execution on your Linux server if you use particular email servers with this particular vulnerable library. Now the good news is GNU fixed this vulnerability long ago. The bad news is many Linux distributions still use the vulnerable library since this wasn't considered a security fix until Qualys reported this. So there are many Linux distribution updates that have come out and will continue to come out to fix this. If you use a Linux server, I highly recommend you install those updates. As a WatchGuard customer, you might be wondering if our Linux-based software is vulnerable. The good news is XCS is not vulnerable. Dimension does use the vulnerable library, but there's an Ubuntu patch that you'll automatically get. In XTM appliances, we use this vulnerable library. However, in our own code, we use an updated function to do DNS resolution, so our code is not vulnerable. That said, some open source software in our product may still use this vulnerable function. We're still researching the impact. No matter what, we'll update glibc, but how soon or late we release the patch depends on if we actually find that we're using this vulnerable function or not. We'll share updates in the future. As an aside, if you're an Apple user, there are some security updates for Apple products as well, and there is even yet another flash update. So besides this big critical Linux issue, if you're an Apple customer or an Adobe customer, check for new updates as well. That's it for today. Thanks for watching.